This is my little disclaimer right here. This camera show everything. God damn. Hey y'all, it's your girl SlayByJ and I am back. Oh my goodness, I know this video is long overdue, but hey, your girl got busy, so had to do what I had to do. Right now, we're about to get straight into it. I'm about to review the infamous E.L.F Makiage foundation and let you guys know how I like it. Did E.L.F Makiage open their purse? I should have done my research. Anywho, this is their Woke Up Like This foundation. Retails for $44 with $6 shipping, so not too bad. Comes in 50 different shades. And if you need help finding your foundation shade, which is what I did, you just go on their website and take their little quiz. They'll ask you multiple questions such as your skin type, what kind of coverage you want. I selected medium to full, and they'll also show you pictures of different models with the foundation on so you can kind of get an idea of what it looks like. They matched me at 165, so we don't see. Yeah, my pump wasn't pumping. I don't even know why I applied my foundation like that. Been watching too many videos on Instagram. What am I doing? With that being said, the consistency is a little on the drippier side. I would kind of compare it to Fenty. I want to say it's a little thicker than Fenty, but not by a lot. Now this does have a matte finish, so as you can see, it's drying pretty quickly, but that ain't no problem. All you gotta do is just blend a little faster. Literally no problem whatsoever. However, my skin is on the dry side right now, so that's why you see the brush kind of dragging a little bit. I don't know if you guys can peep it, but yeah. I really wanted to get a feel for the foundation on its own, so I didn't do it today, but what I usually do is I'll spray some setting spray on my face after I apply my primer, and that just allows the brush to just glide more smoothly. When I tell y'all, I've been seeing this damn foundation everywhere. Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat ads. Like, it's not even funny. It's everywhere. That's why I had to try it. Like, is it really worth the hype? Or are y'all lying? Because don't be lying. Don't make me have to come for y'all. On their website, it's listed as a streak-free foundation that smooths and evens the skin with an advanced innovative formula for a flawless, uniform, natural matte finish. Yikes. I promise I look like somebody off The Walking Dead. Foundation was just a taint light. So what I do? Add more foundation. Make it make sense. On the bright side, at least we know it's buildable. Love that. And it doesn't give you a cake face. Okay. Look, baby, these Prada bags under my eyes are still peeking through, but I ain't mad at it. They're covered for the most part. I was curious to see how this foundation would look after a few minutes, so I went ahead and set my timer for 2 minutes, and I was shook. This is how it looks in natural lighting, and it's damn near a perfect match. Looks just like my skin. But wait, serious question. Is it E.L.F Makiage or E.L.F Makiage? Somebody let me know down in the comments. Okay, I take back my little Walking Dead comment. E.L.F Makiage, snap. They got my foundation shape. Damn, honey. Right now, I'm just doing a subtle highlight using LA Girl Concealer in the shade Fawn. Y'all already know I don't like to highlight my forehead, that mug big enough, but I will be listing all of the products I've used in the description box. This is my first foundation review, y'all, so if there's anything I missed or if you guys still have any questions, please feel free to just drop them down below and I'll be sure to answer them. I got y'all. Y'all notice? Clearly, Laura Mercier has been taking all my coins because I have no translucent powder left. Barely. The rest of this video is pretty much just going to be a tutorial, me finishing my makeup. My eyebrows aren't done, so please ignore that. Whew, quarantine has gotten the best of me. One thing I will say is that this isn't the normal order I do my makeup in. I usually like to do my brows first, then eyes, then face. Even on my clients, I always do face last, but I was just thirsty to try on the foundation. I know, I'm a little thirst bucket, but hey, it's just a natural look, so we Gucci. I'ma let y'all vibe it out though. This voiceover is taking longer than I expected and I need to study. I'm trying to get my aesthetics license, okay? This is the finished look, y'all. I look good. I really do like this foundation. Like I said, it's lightweight, but it's buildable, which I really love. For the next two pictures, the first one is without the flash, and then the second one is with the flash, so it is flashback free.
Oh, fun and gray. Oh, fun and gray.
Thank y'all so much for watching this video. If you like it, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and remember to like, comment, subscribe, donate, and if you're racist, go to hell.